Welcome to Chand Bagh School, Grade 9, Physics, Code 5054, Section 1, General Physics, Lecture Number 6. Dear student, the unit of Section 1 is Physical Quantities, Units and Measurements. We have already discussed about the physical quantities. Types of physical quantities, those are scalar quantities and vector quantities, units, how to use the units and prefixes. Now we are discussing about the measurement techniques. Dear student, in measurement techniques, first of all, we are discussing about the measurement of length. In our previous lectures, we have already discussed how to use the meter ruler. Then the second instrument we have discussed for using measurement of length, that is the measuring tape. The third instrument which we have to use the measurement of length, that is vernier caliper. Now today in lecture number 6, we are going to discuss micrometer screw gauge. Now in diagram, if you see, first of all we will discuss the parts of micrometer screw gauge. A screw gauge or micrometer consists of retached temple, sleeve, spindle and anvil, in which in the spindle we place the object and measure the scale. If you see the diagram, there are two scales in the micrometer screw gauge. The one is a fixed scale, that is called main scale, and this scale consists the reading in millimeters. The other scale is in the round shape, which is moving in a circular path, so that scale is called circular scale. The circular scale is given in divisions. Now the least count or accuracy of micrometer screw gauge is 0.01 millimeter, or if we convert him into the centimeter, so it is 0.001 centimeter. It means that micrometer screw gauge is 10 times accurate than the vernier caliper and 100 times accurate than the meter ruler. So screw gauge is more accurate than the meter ruler and vernier caliper. The screw gauge is used to measure the diameter, the small diameter of bar bearing, or to find the thickness of wire or paper. Dear student, now how to read the screw gauge? Check the zero error by closing the spindle without any object. If value is either added or subtracted if there is any zero error from the final reading. Grab the object between anvil and spindle, and rigid is used to tighten the object into the gap. Read the main scale by noting the last division seen on the sleeve from above diagram. Now in this diagram, main scale reading is equal to 8.5 millimeter. The above division, as you see on main scale, that is 0, and if you see the figure 0 and 5, these show 1 millimeter of each line, but the below line, which do not writing any number on it, that is 0.5 millimeter line. So we have seen the lines of 8.5 millimeter on the main scale. Reading the temple or circular scale division coincided with the dump line, Dumped line is the horizontal line on the main scale. The horizontal line is coincided with the circular scale. So dump or circular scale reading is, that reading is 40 division, because the reading is taken in division. Now this 40 division will be multiplied with the least count, and the least count of micrometer screw gauge is 0.01 millimeter, and the reading is come out to be 0.04 millimeter. Now to take the final reading, the final reading is equal to main scale reading plus circular scale reading. In our case, the main scale reading is 8.5 millimeter and the circular scale reading is 0.40 millimeter. When we add it, we get 8.90 millimeter of that small wire or anything. So this is the whole method to find out the reading with the help of micrometer screw gauge. I hope you will be understand. Keep practicing and best luck for the next time.